latest fad to sweep Silicon Valley might surprise you. It's philosophy, Stoic philosophy to be precise. For the Colson Center, I'm John Stone Street. This is Breakpoint. According to Wikipedia, cultural appropriation is the adoption of elements of one culture by members of another culture. While accusations of cultural appropriation fly around a bit out of control these days, the most contentious example is the taking of cultural artifacts of indigenous peoples, such as Native Americans or Australian Aborigines, by wealthy Westerners who then use the artifacts as hip decorations. This kind of cultural appropriation divorces artifacts from their original context, strips them of their intended meaning. In other words, it ignores the worldviews that produced the artifacts in the first place. Well, speaking of ignoring worldviews that produce artifacts, a recent article from the BBC announced why philosophers could be the ones to transform our year 2020. Apparently, long-dead thinkers from Socrates to Nietzsche are the latest hot property in self-help books. For example, there's the popular book Aristotle's Way, How Ancient Wisdom Can Change Your Life. Or for those who like their wisdom more applied with a hammer, there are all kinds of books now offering a sort of popular twist on the thought of Friedrich Nietzsche, with titles like What Would Nietzsche Do? Or Get Over Yourself, Nietzsche for Our Times. Existentialist philosophers like Camus and Sartre are also getting new life as popular thinkers repurposed for our times. And believe it or not, the hottest philosophers in this new publishing trend are the Stoics. For example, the book How to Think Like a Roman Emperor, The Stoic Philosophy of Marcus Aurelius. There's a strange irony that these ancient philosophers are hitting it big in affluent places like Silicon Valley. As the BBC article notes, the Stoics generally took a dim view of huge wealth. My intention here is not to criticize anyone that's trying to take to heart the wise maxim of Socrates that the unexamined life is not worth living. Still, can't help but think that this is a self-help fad, kind of a first cousin to the mindfulness craze that swept Silicon Valley in the early 2010s. Back in 2013, Wired ran an article proclaiming how meditation could, quote, make your career in the tech capital. But, to paraphrase the car commercial, this wasn't your grandfather's Buddhism, unless your grandfather was a 60s San Francisco hippie. At least, it wasn't the Buddhism of your grandfather if he was Vietnamese or Tibetan. What was then dubbed as Wisdom 2.0, yes, that's what it was really called, was really a Buddhism stripped of any of the dogma and religious trappings. Instead of mimicking that prince who renounced his throne and sat under the Bodhi tree seeking enlightenment and preaching about renouncing ego, Wisdom 2.0 was a sort of utilitarian attempt to use the parts of the religion that could increase productivity and offer an edge on competitors. That's hard to think that in Philosophy 2.0, Aristotle, Socrates, or Marcus Aurelius will fare much better. After all, how can the ethos of Silicon Valley, with all the talk about constant reinvention and utopian technology, be reconciled with the Stoic emphasis on differentiating between what we can change and what we can't? Well, it can't be reconciled. The only option is to appropriate certain artifacts of Stoicism, such as language or certain ideas, and use them to decorate your life, just as you might decorate your walls with a Navajo rug. Of course, the rugs don't make you a Navajo. Quoting Marcus Aurelius in memos won't make you a Stoic either. Chuck Colson used to say that people who identify themselves as spiritual or are rejecting any ultimate authority essentially build God kits for themselves, borrowing bits and pieces from various religions. I call it the buffet approach to worldview, a little of this and a little of that. This utilitarian approach not only ignores essential ideas and concepts and fails to understand them in any original context, it fails to wrestle with the final and ultimate question of whether or not the philosophy is true. We might mention that an awful lot of Sunday morning sermons do kind of the same thing with Jesus' teaching, but that would take another commentary altogether. Either way, in this new trend of philosophical appropriation, the master is the same master of the old trend, me. But Stoic philosophy does sound better than self-help. For Breakpoint, I'm John Stone Street.